The champagne and the final trophy await the European superstar of 1977. Over the last 5 weeks, we've been watching 40 of Europe's champion sportsmen all trying to win a place in this year's Superstar Final. Incidentally, those 40 come from 13 different countries and 20 different sports. Well, now the top eight, the winners, they're back here with us again. This time we're in Rotterdam in Holland, where the climax to the 1977 international competition will be held. Well, behind me is the vast Ahoy Stadium, part of the Ahoy complex, which is now by tradition the home of the European Superstars Final. And later on, our top eight will be in there, getting a taste of the atmosphere, which, as we've seen in the past 2 years, is quite dramatic. Well, before our top eight, our winners, sample that, they had to take part in the opening events like the 100 metres, the canoeing, the swimming, and they're held at venues quite near here. But it's the Ahoy inside there with that Dutch crowd, bell ringing, trumpet blowing, where the deciding events will be held, where we'll see the new champion, the man who picks up the trophy and a cheque for $10,000. Well, that champion will be one of these eight, the eight who've won through and qualified from the heats of this year's European Superstar Tournament. Thijs Kruijzer, Holland, the Olympic hockey player and this year's superstar record point scorer. Hans van Helden, Holland's world champion speed skater who won the heat in Great Britain. Jean-Paul Koch, the very strong French judo man, champion superstar in Belgium. Roger Maas, Belgium, the volleyball international with 275 caps. Herminio Menéndez, a world and Olympic canoe medalist representing Spain. Albert Zweifel, Switzerland's finalist, who's the cyclocross champion of the world. Françoise Traquenelli, Frenchman number two from pole vaulting, the sport that's won all world and European superstar finals. And Keith Fielding, the British Rugby League star who takes them all on for the 1977 European title.
Conditions could not be better to get us underway in this Superstars final for the 100 metres here at the Langerpad track. It's a cinder track, but it's in very good condition. The only superstar that doesn't go in the final is François Traquenelli, the French pole vaulter, who's not allowed to go as an athlete. The rest have committed themselves to it. And of the previous heat winners, there's Hans van Helden has won the 100 metres, and so too has Keith Fielding. But Keith Fielding's win in Vichy in 11 seconds dead makes him the firm favourite. And I think that Keith Fielding and Great Britain could get off to a wonderful start.
Keith Fielding, pretty confident. This man who's always played on the wing in both rugby union and rugby league, never played in any other position, and recognised as a sprinter before he took up rugby. Menéndez, the canoeist who holds the Superstars record for dips, very strong man. And Hans van Helden, known as the fastest speed skater in the world last year. Jean-Paul Koch, national coach for judo now in France, but five times the European champion. And Thijs Kruijzer, winner of the 100 metres in the first ever heat of European Superstars in Aldershot. Eliminated in the heats, Albert Zweifel and Roger Maas. And now, getting ready for the final. On the left, Jean-Paul Koch, Keith Fielding, red top, then Menéndez, Thijs Kruijzer, and far right, Hans van Helden. Kruijzer, with one false start against him, indicated by the flag.
Set.
Fielding away well, so too is Thijs Kruijzer. Fielding beginning to open up a gap already. Koch, the Frenchman, going hard at him, but now Keith Fielding pulls away and pulls away well, and there's going to be 7 or 8 yards. It's Fielding, Kruijzer, Koch, Menendez and Van Helding, and that was another fine win at 100 metres.
So there's the start we'd all hoped for with some confidence, 10 points and victory for Fielding, and only one man not on that first event points table. So that means there's one still to start his bid for the new title, getting ready now for the second event.
Beautiful.
Well, that was Françoise Traquenelli, the French pole vaulter, not actually on course yet for the second event, the canoe race, just undergoing the compulsory indoor safety procedure before the event gets underway. Now, this will be Traquenelli's first event in the Superstars final. He was, of course, banned from the 100 metres, being an athlete. And he's down here with the rest of us at a place called Oldegaard, a very pretty lake next to the Ahoy complex. The canoe race is over a course of 125 metres. And of the seven superstars who've elected to take part, only England's Keith Fielding has previously won this event in the heats throughout Europe building up to this final.
There's the four men in this first heat. Let's have a look at them. The lane one that's nearest us is Thies Kreuzer from Holland, who was second in the canoeing in Switzerland. Next to him in lane two, our man Keith Fielding. Remember his great canoe victory in France when it was very cold, those atrocious conditions. Much better here. Roger Maas, Belgium, is in lane three, and on the form book he's the slowest of the four men in this first heat. And then there's the strongman Jean-Paul Koch, France, judo. He's faster than Fielding on the time he set up in Belgium against Emlyn Hughes. And away they go. Kreuzer, Fielding, Maas, and Jean-Paul Koch on the far side. A little bit of a headwind. You can see how choppy the water is, and that's going to slow them down a little, so the strong men should pull through on this. And Fielding hasn't got a bad start, but Kreuzer pulling away very well in lane one. Fielding looking pretty relaxed. Jean-Paul Koch in a little bit of trouble on the far side. Shorter stroke, but look at the long economic stroke of Thies Kreuzer. That is good canoeing, leaning forward, using the paddle very well indeed, and he has got the lead, and Fielding is not in a good position, not really pulling up as he expected him to. Remember, it's the winner qualifies automatically, the others get through on what the clock says, and Kreuzer's going to get this one. Kreuzer and Fielding's pulled up a little towards the end and gets into second place in that heat, and his time, looking at the clock's 46.93. Now that's not terribly fast, and with another heat to come, he could be in a little bit of a danger. Three men in the second heat. But Kreuzer's through, Fielding will have to wait. That headwind certainly slowing them down, and Fielding not looking as confident as he was in the canoeing in Vichy. Well, the second heat, in fact, only Van Helden, who won it, was faster, so Fielding is into the final, along with Françoise Traquenelli. This is Traquenelli's worst event, but he's got no chance of dropping it because, of course, he's barred from both the 100 metres and the steeplechase. Traquenelli will be in lane one, nearest us, Fielding in two, Kreuzer, Van Helden, and then Roger Maas. The three fastest men in the three middle lanes.
Okay, Mr. Starter.
Traquenelli, Fielding, Kreuzer, Van Helden, Maas. And Kreuzer is away again, and Fielding isn't looking too happy. This is one that Fielding really has to win. It's one of his banker events, having done so well in France, but it's Thies Kreuzer is going ahead, and Van Helden's up as well. Van Helden looking strong, Kreuzer looking strong, and Fielding is right out of it. Fielding completely out of it. It's Kreuzer, Van Helden, a little bit of trouble. Marcel on the far side, one-handed, and Thies Kreuzer forging ahead and looking very good indeed. Kreuzer and Van Helden, Maas up a bit, Fielding is way, way back. And this is a shock for Great Britain, second event for Fielding, one we hoped he'd pick up points, and it's Kreuzer who wins it. From Van Helden, the speed skater, Roger Maas coming up very quickly, and Fielding just getting there into fourth place. That's a bit of a shock, a bit of a bad one for Keith Fielding, and Kreuzer, who is certainly his danger man, picking that up with Van Helden getting the second place. So, a bad result for Fielding. Only 2 points going on the board instead of the 10 he got in this event in his qualifying heat in France. And Kreuzer, his strongest rival for this European title, a very convincing winner. And first place overall for the man who couldn't take his place in this final 2 years ago due to that very bad car crash. Fielding there, 5 points down, lying in second place.
From that lovely outdoor setting for the canoeing, we come inside to the opulence of the Hilton Ballroom for the weightlifting. And it's here, incidentally, that the crossbow shooting will be held later. Five of our superstars go in the weightlifting, but no Keith Fielding. Interestingly enough, all five have clean and jerked more than their own body weight. And of course, it's a competition over body weight. But the favourites must surely be the French. That tough little man from judo, Jean-Paul Coche, has clean and jerked 22.5 kilograms over body weight. And Francois Traquenelli has clean and jerked 24 kilograms over body weight. Now, again, interesting enough, Traquenelli has put on a little weight and Jean-Paul Coche has lost a little weight. But whatever happens, it looks like maximum points for the French.
This is Traquenelli's third and final attempt at 102.5 kilograms. He already has plus 26.3. If he makes this, it gives him plus 28.8. All good clean.
Oh, but not quite there. But he's pushed Coche very hard. He's Traquenelli. It means that Coche now has to lift 107.5 kilograms for victory. It guarantees Traquenelli second place, at least.
This for Coche represents plus 27.2. Superb lifting by the two Frenchmen. £237.
Is he getting... No, he's not made it.
And it's Traquenelli telling you where his problem lies, and he's absolutely right. Step forward rather than back. I think they greatly admire each other's toughness. Different kinds of power and strength required for their sports, for athletics and for judo, but the all-round strength of the judo man is much respected by the athlete. Hoists it up again, no split.
Oh, if he keeps it moving, he's got it. Looks to the referee. The referee agrees. £237 aloft and victory to Jean-Paul Coche. And the first to congratulate him, Francois Traquenelli. First-class competition between these two tough men. 10 points to Coche then, 7 to Traquenelli, 4 to Thies Kreuzer. Roger Maas gets 2 and Menendez 1.
And Coche has suddenly taken over second place. He's now 7 points behind Thies Kreuzer. Fielding there is still third, but of course he wasn't in that weightlifting event, using it as one of the two opt-outs they're all allowed. Fielding instead has decided to go for the swimming, which is next, although he didn't swim when he won Superstars in France. So the rugby league star is obviously doing a few form book calculations.
After the Vichy heat, I decided that my weightlifting just wasn't good enough. I only lifted 1 kilo above my body weight, and I know for a fact that most of the other weightlifting competitors can lift far more than that. So I wouldn't have got any points at all. So it was just a slight gamble on taking the swimming and hoping that my time, which is around about the 35 seconds for 50 meters, will be good enough to give me perhaps fourth or fifth place, which is one or two points definitely more than I get in the weightlifting.
Traquenelli, the Heat 1 winner in the final. Menendez, second, fastest overall. Kreuzer will be in as well. Very much the favourite, I think. Looking very white, I must say. Jean-Paul Coche, who's the third fastest. Very fast, that second heat. And Keith Fielding, who must get 1 point, but obviously is hoping for more. Fielding gambling on the swimming. Traquenelli, Menendez, Kreuzer, Coche, Fielding. And who's got the break? And Fielding not looking all that comfortable at the moment, but Kreuzer's going well and Traquenelli is up. It's Kreuzer and Coche.
Kreuzer in lane three, Kosh in lane four, and Fielding dropping back just a little. Kreuzer, lane three, Kosh, lane four, Menendez in lane two, and it's Thies Kreuzer coming up. Thies Kreuzer, his white back showing out through the water, and Kosh is up with him as well, and Thies Kreuzer, the Dutchman, and Jean-Paul Kosh and Fielding, look at him in the lane nearest us, dropping right back, and it's coming up to the line, and it's Kreuzer who touches from Kosh, from Menendez, from Tracanelli. Now that's a bit of a shock. He looks so good in that other heat, and Keith Fielding just coming in, last place, but he gets a point. But it's Kreuzer's second win of the Superstars so far. Remember, he won the canoeing. Fielding, he improved by over 3 seconds in that final, but just gets a point, which, as he forecast, is better than he would have done in the weightlifting.
Kreuzer now has a very substantial lead with 31 points from Kosh on 21, and Keith Fielding is still in third place, but with only 13 points from three events.
So the cyclocross champion of the world, the tough, stocky little Albert Zweifel from Switzerland, is the only man still to get off the mark in his 10-sport superstar final. But here, back inside again, the form book shows that not only should he get his first points at the competition, but he should also win the next event. Because it's the new one of crossbow shooting, and Zweifel won this in his heat in Madrid, he scored a very good 46 out of a possible 50 with his five shots. But I think that one of his danger men could be the Dutch speed skater Hans van Helden, triple bronze medalist in the Winter Olympic Games, and the only one of the six taking part here who's previously shot two bulls. And back here in the ballroom, as we join the crossbow shooting, Zweifel's target is 45 to lead, because Tracanelli has already shot a 44, Maas a 43, and Menendez a 39. Here's Zweifel, first shot. 4 nines and a bull in Spain. Oh, might be just a nine, but it's right in, no, it's an eight.
Acht.
Definitely an eight.
Eight.
Fielding, yet to go. 43, his best ever. That's got to be right in the middle of the 10.
Dean, 10.
Zweifel looking for his first points of the competition. Could be another 10. Rule is, if it cuts the line, the higher score counts. But it's almost on the mark.
Eight. Nine.
Oh, he's given him a nine. Well, I would have been sure that was a 10, but he's the man on the mark, and he's the man that shouts the score. Nine. Quiet, rather shy little man. And 10? Or is it just gone off to the right? It's making quite a big hole as it comes through.
Negen. Nine.
Another nine. So 8, 10, 9, 9, Tracanelli, leader at the moment. Zweifel needs 9 or 10 to go ahead of him. Last shot. Oh, he's let it fly away again. Must be an eight. Don't call it a seven, surely.
Eight. Acht.
Eight it is.
Total points, 44.
Doing the adding up for us. 44 for Zweifel, which means it's equal with Tracanelli. Hans van Helden next to shoot. Keith Fielding still to come. He needs an eight or better to take the lead. Must be another 10.
Dean.
Yes.
10.
Two 10s for Van Helden in that round.
Total punten 47. Total points 47.
Judge is just checking. It's 47. So he leads. Tracanelli and Zweifel are equal second with 44. Good shooting, 47. This is, in fact, the same crossbow as being used in Spain. So with a number of qualifiers from Spain, they should really have an advantage. Fielding, of course, was in France. It's quite a different weapon. Zweifel, who was hoping for points and may get some, but won't get the winner's position. So what can Fielding do with it? 47 to beat. 43 he scored in France. Nine.
Negen. Nine.
Got
three nines and two eights for his 43 in France. Oh, I think it's a 10. It'll be the first one he's ever got with a crossbow, if it is.
Dean.
Yes?
10.
He's got one. Remember, it's 47 he's aiming for. 48 to win. Pulled that one rather quickly.
Eight.
Yes, he's paid the penalty for it, an 8. So that's 27 in three shots, and he needs two 10s now to be equal first with Van Helden. I don't think he's got one with that.
Nine.
So he needs an 8 or better now for second place. Oh, he's got a 10. A 10 he scored with that last one.
Dean.
Yes.
10.
Which means he's missed equal first by one shot. He could have got equal first, 1 point out of it. But he gets 7 points, and that's really a bonus, because neither Kreuzer or Kosh were in that, both opting out. So we now get a very true picture of the state of the final at the halfway stage. The top three have all done the same number of events. Fielding is now only 1 point away from Kosh in second place, and Kreuzer 10 points clear at the top. And the cheers from this capacity crowd of 8,000 as most of them see the superstars for the first time. The start of the second day, five more events to do. Kreuzer on the left there in the lineup, in the rostrum. Kosh is next to him, then Zweifel, then Keith Fielding in the middle. Menendez, Roger Maas, Francois Tracanelli and Van Helden. Yes, and Keith Fielding has spotted somebody in the crowd. He's got at least one fan there. And the first event for this massive crowd to watch is a pretty dramatic one, and Ron Pickering now describes it for us.
Well, far from the usual Spartan atmosphere of the gymnasium, this is rather more like a circus as they get ready for the dips on parallel bars to be followed by the squat thrusts. Jean-Paul Kosh, first to go for France. Jean-Paul Kosh, last time we saw him, scored 30. Arthur Judge.
Four, five, six,
and the crowd already joining in.
Eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, straightening, 22, 23, 24.
Referees docked him one. 26, 27, 28. Must fully lock 30, at the elbows 30, on straightening and bend his 32, arms to 90 seconds, degrees. 30, he's well past his previous score. Remember, it's the number of dips in 1 minute. Oh, that's that point of no return for Jean-Paul Kosh, but I think he's got a score of 40.
He got only 40 seconds.
And local favourite, Hans Van Helden. He only did 14 dips last time.
One, two, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Trying to get a rhythm going.
8, 9, 10.
And remember, it's not the number of dips added to the number of squat thrusts. It's a two-part competition like the soccer, and it's positions which are taken into account before the final position for the gymnasium test is given. He's dropping just that left shoulder. He's already improved.
30 seconds.
On his best, if he locks at the elbows, he'll get 18. Hans Van Helden, 18. Maas there has scored 27, Roger Maas. And the next man to go is this very tough Spaniard, Herminio Menendez, who has the superstars record of 51 dips in 1 minute.
Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Cracking start.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9,
10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21.
The leader, I remember, Jean-Paul Koch, on 40.
25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40.
Up to Koch's score. This is the training for canoeing. Jean-Paul Koch can only stand and stare.
46, 47, 48.
I don't think he's going to better his previous score there.
49, 50.
He's pushing on because he knows Tracanelli's still to come, at least. 50, and down he goes on 50. Menendez takes the lead with 50 dips.
And
the 8,000 crowd being well entertained. Now, Zweifel's just been and scored 20, so it's now up to Francois Tracanelli. And the pole vaulters usually do very well at this, but one or two other specialists have crept in, certainly that canoeist and the judo man.
21, 22, 23.
Not too happy. He doesn't look that confident.
26, 27, 28.
Oh, and he's dropped out. Now that's clearly because he's overtaken Roger Maas's score and doesn't feel he's capable of catching Jean-Paul Koch or, of course, Menendez. So Menendez has first place, Koch has second, and Tracanelli has third place, and they carry those places over. There's Menendez's 50 on the scoreboard. Tracanelli, 28, one more than Roger Maas. Now for the squat thrusts, and it's the number they can do in 1 minute. I think Tracanelli was indicating that he had a bit of a muscle soreness or a twitch. And they line up Koch on the left, Van Helden, Menendez, Maas, Zweifel, and Tracanelli. Heels of the hand beyond the front line, feet beyond the second line.
Are you ready?
Where they go. Good start by Koch on the left. Very quick, pumping. Next to him, Van Helden's got that very wide leg stance. Menendez going well, driving hard. And then Maas, two, and then Zweifel. And Tracanelli at this end. And they're all going well. Now, Koch last time scored 71, Van Helden 68, Maas didn't go last time, Menendez 65, Zweifel only 52, but I thought he was robbed, and Tracanelli had 67. And Tracanelli slowed a little bit, and the man who looks to be going the fastest to me is Koch, far left. There he is. He really is driving hard. 45 seconds gone. And this is where the positions are going to matter. Menendez, of course, led at the end of the dips, but I think this man, Koch, may have won the squat thrust. And of course, if Koch gets a first and second place, he could still win the overall gymnasium test. Francois Tracanelli, not very confident about his squat thrust. And the two Frenchmen confer. There's the scores. Koch, 77. Van Helden, 71. Menendez, only 72. Maas, 57. Zweifel, 70. Tracanelli, 73. So Koch wins with a first and second place, beating Menendez, who had a first and third place. Tracanelli gets the 4 points.
That was Fielding's second and last opt-out. He's still hanging on to that third place, but by only a point. And right down to sixth place, it's anybody's final. But a few minutes later, Thies Kreuzer had pulled a fast one, sharing the football with Menendez, the event that Kreuzer claimed was his weakest. It was almost a triple tie because Keith Fielding lost out not on goals, but by 2 seconds on the clock in the slalom. And how the fastest man in the Superstar final did that is something of a mystery. So, out of the football, Fielding got 4 points, 8.5 each for the joint winners, which means that overall, Kreuzer, Koch and Fielding are still 1-2 and 3.
Our next event is the obstacle course. You'll remember it was the Americans that introduced the obstacle course to the World Superstars final last year. And then we at Welwyn Garden City invented our own for the British heat of European Superstars. Well, the Dutch have copied that pretty much, but there are two different elements. One, the superstar has to carry these two dumbbells weighing a total of 30 kilograms, and he carries them up these steps and deposits them here. And then, having crossed the high jump bar, he must climb a 4-meter rope and down before going on to the balance beam and the hurdles. All eight superstars go, and remember, as usual, it's a race against the clock.
And still this atmosphere being maintained in the Ahoy Stadium. Keith Fielding lines up with Roger Maas. This tough Belgian fireman, very good, remember him winning the basketball. And he's pretty agile. Keith Fielding looking for points here. Over that box and the horse, just about level, bouncing two legs together, and now the hand walk. They must go beyond the white tape marks, and a slight lead to Roger Maas. Fielding running though, carrying those weights over the high jump bar, both make it very easily. Now the rope climb. Keith Fielding not using legs, arms only, pretty good, touches the top and has got a very good lead. Now the balance beam, which can ruin everything. Got to do a 360 degree turn, but Keith Fielding is safely away. Three hurdles to negotiate, and then up to the line, and takes it well. 34.56 for Keith Fielding. There it is, beats Roger Maas on 36.31. Now Francois Traquenelli lines up with Albert Zwijfel. Traquenelli this side absolutely hurdling that box, getting stuck a little bit on the horse, but going away again. Traquenelli opening up quite a lead. I think he'll hop over that, no problem at all. Couple of hauls on the rope and he's clear and pops up onto the beam with ease. Zwijfel still making the climb to the top, and Traquenelli hurdles well, and that must be a very fast time indeed. It is. He's beaten 30 seconds, 29.27, and Zwijfel still coming home. Just past 42 seconds for Zwijfel. Traquenelli must feel that this is an event designed for him. Now Jean-Paul Koch lines up with Van Helden. Koch sharing the lead at the moment. Koch did well there. Short, but leapt on. He's lost the lead though, about a yard or two. Oh, look at his arms. Tremendous arm strength, whips him into the lead. Those dumbbells hardly weigh anything to him. Great piece of rope climbing too, straight down. That's simply how fast he can go. Traquenelli's time the fastest so far, 29.27. But if he can get near that, he'll go with Traquenelli in the final, and I think he will. He's faster than Fielding, 31.49. Van Helden still struggling a little bit. And out of the points for Van Helden. Yes, signals to Traquenelli that they're the two that have made the final. And Thies Kreuzer had something of a disaster. His first run, he dropped the dumbbells. He had a second rerun, but could only record 36.94. So he doesn't make either of the runoffs. Now the final. Koch on the far side, Traquenelli this side. Traquenelli absolutely hurdling that box. Two jumps and he's over the bench. Now he knows that Koch is tough in the arms, but Traquenelli still well clear. Oh, he's sailing this, providing there are no disasters on the beam. Gets his 360 degree turn in early and then away. And Koch has fallen off, so the 10 points will go to Traquenelli. And Jean-Paul Koch will get the 7, the all-French final. And that's going to make some differences to the scoreboard. Trakanelli, a very easy win indeed. There's the 10 points for him. Kosh gets 7, Menendez 4, Keith Fielding only 2. And that will be reflected on the master scoreboard. Thies Kreuzer, 39.50. Kosh close in contention with 38, but look at Keith Fielding down in 5th place with only 26 points.
That leaves us with just two events to decide this 1977 Superstar Championship, and there's a total prize fund of $23,000 resting on the top four places. Well, both of those events take place here on the track of the Ahoy, and in both of them we have three previous winners. Van Helden, Keith Fielding and Trakanelli have all been cycling champions. Van Helden again, Menendez and Kreuzer have all won a steeplechase in the heats. Well, the cycle race is first. It's a new type event. They have a rolling start, and then it's flat out, one lap, start to finish.
And this Dutch crowd are cycling fanatics. So many big bike races being held here in the Ahoy, and Keith Fielding has got the worst draw of all. He's got to go first on his own to set the standard. He'd love to have sat back and watched to see what some of his rivals were going to do, what times they set up, but he's the man who has to go first, and the rest will follow. Goes away. He has one warm-up lap. It's a 200-meter track.
And daar is hij weg voor zijn warming-up ronde. En zodra hij dan weer aan de meet komt, dames en heren, dan zal u hem natuurlijk. U bent sportief, min in Nederland.
Rolling start, and he's going right up high on the bank to get this sweep down onto the line because the time starts there, and he's away. 200 meters, my goodness, he went high to get that sweep on, and listen to this crowd. And that is fast. Fielding really pushing this, not going quite as high, but it's good bike riding. Coming in towards the line. And the unofficial time, 13.64 for Keith Fielding. And if it's true, it's 33 miles an hour around this track. And that is incredible. Fielding time being confirmed by the judges at 13.64. 10 points here. And Fielding is right back in business for the European Superstar title.
Jean-Paul Kosh on the warm-up. Didn't make the cycle finals in Belgium. He's now second place overall, 1.5 points down on Kreuzer. That time of Fielding's 13.64. Quite unbelievable. And he really is back in strong contention for the Superstar title if he can have a win in the cycling. And Kosh is away. Doesn't look quite as quick as Fielding. Wobbling just a little. Fielding's line was better. Coming in, and there's the unofficial time, 14.57. Much, much slower than Fielding. Unofficial times to be confirmed by the judges. Francois Trakanelli, who won the cycling in Spain. And remember, he put Tim Crooks out of the final. Now, ironically, if he gets a better time than Fielding now, he'll almost certainly put Fielding out of the race for the title. Trakanelli seeming to be Britain's bogeyman. Pretty dramatic figure in his black tracksuit bottoms. Going pretty high. The bell.
And
on the clock. He looks quite fast, but is he fast enough? Coming in, and no. 14.26, the unofficial time for Trakanelli, outside Fielding. And we've just got an update on Jean-Paul Kosh's time, 14.1, not 14.57, but still outside Fielding. Trakanelli's time just confirmed at 14.26, so Fielding's still all right. That means that Trakanelli can't win the Superstars. A first time a pole vaulter hasn't won a Superstar final. But here's Van Helden, the speed skater, the biggest danger to Fielding, and he knows it. Speed skaters always win the bike races in Superstars. They train on bikes really made for this event. And Hans Van Helden is the one now that can upset all the hopes of Great Britain and Keith Fielding. Remember Johan Granath from Sweden, the speed skater here last year, when he did 4 laps from a standing start inside 1 minute. Van Helden. And that's quick. That is quick. Won the bike race in Great Britain. And he's on. Oh, just outside. 13.72 on the screen. But remember, that clock has been almost half a second out. We wait.
Looks like it's all right by the sounds of it. I think.
13.71. Just a tenth of a second slower.
There's one to go.
And the one to go is Thies Kreuzer. If he wins, Fielding has had it. And in Switzerland, remember, Kreuzer was second to the skier Bernard Russi in the cycle race. Fielding, first man to go. Set that time. 13.64. I said to sit and watch all these. And now just Kreuzer to try and put him out. On the clock. The Dutch crowd roaring Kreuzer around. And he's not going to do it. He's over the 14, if that's confirmed.
Yes!
And Fielding's seen it.
Yes, he is.
Kreuzer's time is confirmed and Fielding has won the bike race.
Oh, yes, I did. I was waiting for it.
It must have been agony having to go first and watch those guys.
It was terrible. It really is bad.
It was painful for us.
Yeah, I bet it was. I bet it was. Oh, it's murder.
Where'd you learn to ride a bike like that?
I said to David in Vichy, cycling up this hill on the way to school. It's a hill called Danbank, and boy, it's treated me well. It really has.
That was fantastic piece of riding. It really was.
Well, all you needed was your confidence to get up this bank here and use the bank. You get to gain your speed.
But you can't be used to that. Whatever Bank's got, it's got no bank like this.
No, sir. You just gotta say to yourself, if you're gonna have a chance of winning, you've got to do it.
And you learned that just in the practice.
Yeah.
Well, magnificent 10 points, Keith. Well done.
Thanks very much.
Great stuff.
Great. Thanks very much.
And what can those 10 points do for Fielding now? With that victory, becomes the first man ever to beat a speed skater in Superstars cycling. But it's not just a cycle victory, because it means that he's right back in with a great chance of taking the European Superstar title. One event to go, that's the steeplechase, and Fielding could win it with that. It'll be the first time anybody from Great Britain has done it. Kreuzer has lost his lead overall, and Kosh, the man who's overtaken him, has done all his 8 events. If Fielding wins this last one, Kreuzer must be second to beat him for the title. It's on the track.
And 40 competitors have fought their way through 5 heats of European Superstars and 9 events in this final, and still there is no clear-cut winner. There is, for Keith Fielding, only one option: to go out and win this steeplechase and pray that this man, Thies Kreuzer, can do no better than third. For if he finishes second or first, he wins. Hans van Helden from ice skating is in the lineup of 5 competitors, and the other great threat is Herminio Menendez, the bearded man on Fielding's right, who's already beaten Keith Fielding in a steeplechase. 3 laps of the track. Keith Fielding must go out and try to win, and for Kreuzer, he must come first or second, and it's Fielding that's gone into an early lead. Menendez is in second place, just being overtaken by van Helden. And the danger man is way at the back at the moment. Kreuzer at the back. Fielding pushing on and opening up a very big lead. And that's all he can do. And there's no water jump on the first lap. Menendez thought there was. He's gone back onto the circuit. 3 laps of this 200-meter race. And Menendez burning down the far side, trying to get on terms and going into second place. And Kreuzer moving up through the field all the time. But Fielding has committed himself totally and utterly. He set an almost suicidal pace, and over 600 meters he could find that he's running out of steam at the end. Over the water jump, there he goes. It's a clean water jump. Menendez in second. Kreuzer stumbles a bit and takes his time over that one. And still Kreuzer is third and way back, 30 or 40 yards adrift of Keith Fielding, who's doing everything right. And Menendez is in second, and Kreuzer's closing the gap on him. Zweifel bringing up the rear. And the legs are beginning to go. The pace returns to sanity. Fielding climbs over that hurdle. Kreuzer's now on the shoulder of Menendez. And if he can get second, he wins Superstars overall. And Fielding cannot see what's happening behind him. He drags himself out of the water, into the home straight for the last time. And he must believe he's won it. He's done everything so right. His legs are beginning to turn to water. His arms are aloft in victory, but he cannot see that Kreuzer has got second place over the last 5 yards. He snatched the victory away from Keith Fielding, and that is cruel. Fielding did everything absolutely right, but so too did Kreuzer. He timed it magnificently and stole it on the line. And for Fielding, the realization that all that effort leaves him in second place overall, when he must have believed that he had the title in his hand.
That was truly magnificent. It really was. It must have been both the ecstasy of winning and the agony of seeing Kreuzer coming in second. You've never run like that before in your life, I'll guarantee, Keith.
Never. Oh, it's a damn bloody shame, that.
Magnificent. Hey, good effort by Kreuzer, though. He really had to dog the rest.
Yeah. I knew what I had to do. I went out to do it. And I just had a hope.
I tell you what, Keith, that's the best ever effort we've had in a European final by a British superstar.
Well, really was superb. As long as I've not let anybody down, that's another thing.
Man, it was magnificent.
Yes, she.
Jeez, many congratulations.
Thank
that
you
really
very much.
Was a tremendous effort.
Yeah.
I don't think we've ever had a closer superstars, do you?
No, I'm sure we didn't have.
It must have given you a real pleasure to have come back, because the first time we saw you, you won well, and then you had the bad accident.
Yeah.
To come back to first-class hockey and to come back and win European Superstars, this must be a magic moment.
Well, it's a great moment because, well, in March this year, I made my comeback for the hockey. And to be honest, I very much would like to come back in Superstars as well. And finally the invitation came, so I was very pleased to get that one. And I've been in Neuchâtel and now here. Yeah. And well, it's great for me.
At one stage you looked as though you were running away with this title.
Yeah,
and then
that's
they
right.
Closed the gap on your heart. John
well,
Kosh,
yesterday I sported, as I may say, rather good. Thanks. But today, in the first two events, the, how do you call that in English?
Where the obstacle course.
The obstacle course.
Yeah.
And the bicycling are not my strongest sport. Yeah. So before these two events, I said to myself, well, any point I can get is okay. And I was lucky to get a big lead after yesterday.
Sure.
And well, I knew that with the football, with the soccer, and with the steeplechase, I should get some points anyway.
Sure.
So, well, I counted a bit, and finally I said to myself, well, it must be able to win. And finally I won.
Good. But Keith Fielding going out in front, he did everything right as far as he was concerned,
yes.
But he also helped to pull you. You knew exactly what you had to do.
No, well, before we started to run, Keith, and by the way, he's a very good chap. He became a kind of a friend to you during
I'm
these
sure.
3 days. But he said to me, well, the only thing I can do is becoming number one. And I said to him, then I must be number two.
That's
and that's the way it went. And when he finished, he thought he won and put his hands in the air.
Yeah.
And then he looked back
and, you were in
and
second.
Saw me coming
yeah.
as number second. And then he fell down. Well, it was a pity because he ran a marvelous race.
Tees Kreuzer, it was a tremendous privilege to be here and see you win it. Well done indeed. We're all proud for you.
Thank you very much.
Kreuzer, by just 2.5 points from Fielding, Kosh, the French judo man, is third. And that is the closest and most dramatic Superstars final we've ever seen. And so, from those 40 international sportsmen from 13 countries and 20 different sports, the announcements for the men who take the honors, Jean-Paul Kosh. Third place for Kosh, unbeatable in the strength events of weightlifting and gymnasium. Third place and $4,000 and the prizes from Ada Kok, the great Dutch swimmer, now a television sports commentator. Jean-Paul Kosh, his strength really coming through for that third place.
Keith Fielding!
And Fielding from Rugby League getting a tremendous reception. For a moment in that steeplechase, he was the champion. But even now, his runner-up, the finest performance ever put up by a British superstar.
Thank you, Keith Fielding. Very nice to have you here in Rotterdam.
A nice tribute to Fielding. He takes $6,000. And so, the champion. Kreuzer in front of his home crowd, who won a place in the final 2 years ago, but ended up in hospital instead after that terrible car accident, wins the title for Holland and the sport of hockey, who get his prize, being an amateur, of $10,000. And even though, for a moment, as Kreuzer holds the trophy aloft and this Dutch crowd really applaud him to the skies, for a moment, it'll be all champagne and glory. But amid the champagne, well, Kreuzer is looking ahead to his second Olympic Games in Moscow. Keith Fielding for Great Britain. Well, he'll be back to Rugby League with Salford and Great Britain. And Jean-Paul Koch will return home to France to coach the national judo team, of which he's been the most famous member. But there's another superstars ahead for those three as well. They now take on champions from outside Europe, and we go with them to the United States next year for the Superstar Championship of the World.